What's up, guys? Welcome back. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are listening or watching this wonderful channel from. This is Jungleless Entertainment. As you know, here we'll give you updates of all the trends and happenings in Nigeria, Africa, and if you are new here, be kind enough to hit the subscribe button and the bell notification so as to be updated. Well, as I said earlier, this channel is strictly based on entertainment, though we give you other gists in politics, new cars, new designer, everything that keeps you entertained or that keeps you afloat with the times. Talking about entertainment, congratulations to Wizkid. You know, Wizkid is a funny guy. Wizkid has been doing numbers. He has been doing numbers right from time, but when he released his album Made in Lagos, man, the number size has skyrocketed, and especially with the song Essence. We see so many musicians in the United States, in UK, globally, vibing and dancing to the song. So many remixes. Talking about Wizkid, we got this news yesterday. You know, Wizkid is full of surprises. Music, entertainment generally is full of surprises. It gives you something to expect, to want more. Wizkid gave his fans something interesting to talk about as he showed massive support for his colleague B.O.J. in London. The singer got the concert goers screaming as he joined B.O.J. on stage and performed one of his evergreen songs. Reacting, someone wrote, "This music game would have been boring without Machala." Adap said, "Wizkid be like Nepa. You can't predict him. You can't predict Wizkid." Wizkid, big ups and congratulations. He'll be doing very well. And we know Wizkid has promised us that he'll be dropping his album, More Love, Less Ego. We are eagerly anticipating that album. Well done, Wizkid. And we know this, according to singer Davido, he said, "We rise by lifting others." And Davido has been doing his best to lift others. We see him performing in different countries, especially when he performed at the O2 Arena. He went with other Nigerian musicians. Same with Wizkid. Big ups and congratulations to all the musicians doing numbers and pushing each other up, and most importantly, taking the country to greater heights when it comes to entertainment. I still believe strongly that when it comes to entertainment, we are still the giant of Africa. What about the comment section is open for you? Talking about Nigeria being the giant of Africa when it comes to music, congratulations to Leku. We have this good that Leku, now a voting member of Grammy. Wow, reality TV and singer Leku is now a voting member of Recording Academy, the Grammys. That is huge. As I've been saying, there's one good about Big Brother Nigeria. Whether you win the money or not, you come home smiling. If you go there as Mr. A, you definitely come back as Mr. A plus, or Miss A, you definitely come back as Miss A plus. That is one good thing about the people that Nigeria show. These guys have been doing wonders. You can imagine Leko, fine, he won the people that Nigeria show and decided to go into singing. Look at where it has landed him now. He can vote for the Grammy. From the desk of the Recording Academy or the Grammys, he says voter participation is paramount to maintaining hashtag Grammys integrity. Voting members, you have the power to celebrate your fellow creators who move music forward. This year's first round voting period is open until October 23rd. And you can see Lekong's picture there, voting for the Grammys. That's a huge one. Congratulations and big ups to all the Nigerian musicians who have been taking Afrobeats to greater heights. Big ups. You guys are talking about the Big Brother Niger. The season 7 just ended with the winner going home with about 100 million naira. We have this news that the Big Brother Nigeria reality TV show ITA is at risk of being banned. Several petitions and allegations have greeted the show, accusing it of offending Nigeria's cultural and traditional values. The Muslim Student Society of Nigeria recently said it's duty bound on all well-meaning Nigerians to also join the call for this regulation about before we all lose hope of the truth. Well, the Islamic group wants Big Brother Niger banned. Bob Risky, James Brown arrested by federal government. What do you have to say regarding that? They want the cross-dressers to be arrested by the federal government, and they want the Big Brother Niger show to be banned. Talking about the Big Brother Niger, we used to have other shows in Niger, like the Good Ultimate Search, so many shows, Niger Sings. All of a sudden, those ones died. But the Big Brother Niger is still standing. People are calling this thing to be banned. This is really what helps some people stay glued to their television, because the economy is not rosy. People have been complaining about the economy of the country and so many drama that happened in the country. But watching this show keeps people going. That's why we see so many people voting, going the extra miles. You get to know people you have not known before. You get to make friends. Some people go as far as opening WhatsApp groups just to chat with individuals. To me, it's one thing that unites the country and keeps people glued to their television. If the Big Brother Nigeria is crap, what do we stand to gain from that? Well, the comment section is open. We're talking about Bobrisky and James Brown. These guys are cross-dressers, and they'll be making money. And we see so many people emulating them. They want to be cross-dressers. Recently, we saw this guy who came up and told us about what he's going through right now, that he tattooed Bobrisky's face on his body, and during the process, he contracted HIV. And he was sending messages to Bobrisky to assist him. People have gone as far as, getting tattoos of Bobrisky's. Sometimes, and especially the ladies out there, we see when Bobrisky was celebrating her birthday, we see the number of ladies that were flocking. Some people went as couples, husband and wife, going to Bobrisky's birthday. Well, that is their decision. Funny enough, when we talk about feminism, most of them are Bobrisky fans. I don't know why people don't like emulating Ngozi Okonjo-Iweala. I checked her up on Instagram. I saw the number of followers. It's terrible indeed. We have so many fans out there who prefer Bobrisky, and most of them are female. Well, the Islamic group is asking the federal government to arrest Bobrisky and James Brown. What do you have to say regarding that? Leave the comment section is open for you to drop your comments. Let us move on to another part of entertainment, movies. I love movies. We have this good news. Nigeria is growing when it comes to entertainment. Don't forget that. The African premiere of Black Panther, Wakanda Forever, will hold in Lagos, Nigeria. Isn't that wonderful? Ahead of its November 11 release, Marvel Studios' Black Panther, Wakanda Forever, will hold its African premiere in Lagos, Nigeria. The Walt Disney Company, in association with Africa International Film Festival and FinOne Entertainment, announced that the premiere will hold early in November in Nigeria's Entertainment Center, which is Lagos. That is a huge one. We can't wait for that movie, Wakanda Forever. It will be dropping next month. We can't wait. We can't wait. Personally, I can't wait. I'll go to the cinemas to see
Let
that
us move on
movie.
to something else.
So many things have been changing in Nigeria, not just in Nigeria, but globally. And once again, congratulations to the Real Madrid striker Karim Benzema. He won the 2022 Ballon d'Or award. That's the biggest award when it comes to football. Big ups and congratulations to Karim Benzema. As I be saying most of my video, do you really think he should have won the award? Because last time I see when with the awards, people were complaining that no, probably when those people would have won that award. Do you really think Karim should have won that award, the Ballon d'Or for 2022? The comment section is open for you. So many things have been going on in Nigeria. Recently, there was this drama between Bimbo and her rich husband, IVD Autos. Well, Bimbo is late. He's late now. Talking about the drama that's been going on, I've been posting in most of my videos. You can go back and check them out. Blessing CEO is in the news for the wrong reason again. And this time is because she's going against the family of late Bimbo. The relationship experts accuse the family members of being after the properties and life of late Bimbo's rich husband, IVD. According to her, the late Bimbo's sister, Mama Jazz, wasn't even on talking terms with her deceased siblings. What do you have to say regarding that? Blessing CEO is supporting IVD. And other people are supporting Bimbo. Who are you in support of? Please, the comment section is open
Let
for
us
you.
move on to politics in Nigeria. We have this drama,
not just Nigeria, that China.